So welcome, I'm Ashok Kumar.
We have, sir, please give us a brief introduction about yourself and what you do, and tell us about how these kind of events could impact to all the beginner developers and, you know, all the people who are aspiring to learn and explore Kotlin technologies or happening Android technologies and all these questions.
Yeah, welcome Ashok.
Thank you, sir.
Thanks for giving me this opportunity to share my experience. So what I've been doing is I've started my career when like things were monochrome, then we went to LED, and now we are with something more, you know. So the things is, I've seen the past, present and future of tech, and with event like this, what we are trying to do is to motivate beginners and they get insight into future tech. Plus, what we are trying to do is provide them sessions which are full of code and content, not just talk. So they get the much needed start that they are looking for, and then they start exploring new things, and that provides them with the kind of opportunity which they might have never thought of.
Correct, sir. So when we were starting our technical programming learning curve, so there was no such sessions or meetups and all this, but now we have like experts like you and open-minded people. We all are contributing. So how is this open source and events like this will impact developers? For example, will it give them an exposure of seeking different speakers' viewpoint on particular technologies, or how does it work?
So how this works is we select from long list of speaker engagement offers, and we try to have the kind of speaker who can provide more into less time. And I had seen in Silicon Valley last year that they have about, I would say, in thousands meetups every month. So in order to reach to that stage, we have to start somewhere. Yes. And that's something we are doing under the banner of GDG Ahmedabad.
Correct.
So it's a long-term process. But yes, if beginners, they come to events like this, they come to regular meetups, then definitely they will improve, brush their skills, and then they can learn from kind of speakers we are having.
Yes. Like about 1,200 registrations, and like you guys have to say no for hundreds of attendees. Like, how do you feel about that?
It's a good problem to have when this is a problem of plenty, right. And we are very happy about it. Mm-hmm. So we could, in like only last 4 years, mm-hmm. could create a culture which is generating so much of interest into things like this, and we love to have problem like this in future as well.
All right, sir. Pleasure speaking to you. Thank you so much.
Thank you.
Hi guys, we have Paresh here with us, and let's understand his insights about DevFest Ahmedabad 2017, and here we go.
Yeah. Hi, Akshay. So thank you. And hey, guys, I am Paresh Mayani, and I am the founder, organizer of this DevFest event, mm-hmm. or I would say, like, I'm looking after GDG Ahmedabad. Mm-hmm. And apart from managing community, I would say I'm one of the early Android adopter. Mm-hmm. And I have been learning Android development since 2009. And also, like, I have contributed over different platforms like Stack Overflow, mm-hmm. where I am holding more than 80,000 reputation.
Brilliant.
Yeah, and I also published 150 articles over my blog, technotalkative.com. Oh. And then I also delivered talks in different communities and events like Android Developer Days Ankara, that is capital of Turkey. Mm-hmm. And I have also been to SFO last year. I was invited to attend Google I/O 2015.
Brilliant.
Yeah, and so apart from doing all this community work, I am also working as a technical lead for Android, mm-hmm. at Symphom Solutions Private Limited, mm-hmm. where we provide solutions, mobile and web solutions to our clients. So they have their own products and ideas, and we provide them service and solutions, mm-hmm. and we give them their ideas into execution.
Paresh, a quick question. Like, how do you think an event like this will impact beginners and intermediate level developers? And what could be their takeaways, like, post the session? Like, what should they do or what shouldn't they supposed not to be doing.
Yeah, so as I mentioned in my starting session or 5 minute session, so as I said, like there are for the very first time we are hosting 600 participants, mm-hmm. and out of that we have invited around 200 to 250 students, and they are like graduated or they have just started their career with Android and web development and cloud development. Mm-hmm. So it is an opportunity for them to meet industry experts and experienced people, so that you know they can ask questions, they can interact with, and they can get to know lot many things, like how to grow their career, what they should do, what they should not. So it is an opportunity, I would say.
Okay.
And also there are speakers from different regions of India, like Bangalore, mm-hmm. and Pune, mm-hmm. Bombay, mm-hmm. and then there are 5 speakers from Ahmedabad itself.
All right.
So it is a platform. It is like this event where we invite speakers from other regions.
Okay.
So that they get an opportunity to meet and to learn from industry experts. In monthly meetup, we just invite local our experts and techie guys.
Okay.
So it is an opportunity to meet industry experts from different regions.
Correct. All right.
Yeah.
So it could be an exposure to all the beginners and
right.
All right. Thank you, Paresh.
Yeah. Thank you, Ashok.
Thank you so much. Thank you.
Hi there. I'm Ashok Kumar. We have Drumil with us. Let's understand his point of view about these kind of events and how to change or how does it matters to a common developer and all that kind of questions. Hey, Drumil.
Hi, Ashok. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. Drumil, so you've been developing Android apps.
Yes, I am.
So since when?
Okay, so I have started Android development since Android 2.1.
Oh, you're like that early bird developer.
Yes, I am.
All right. So, Drumil, a straightforward question, like how does these kind of events will change like a common or a beginner's, how does it impact to a developer?
Okay, so let me just, you know, share my experience that what me and our team is doing at GDG Ahmedabad. Mm-hmm. So I'm the co-organizer at GDG Ahmedabad.
Right.
What we are doing is we are running this community, mm-hmm. this especially tech community,
right.
in Ahmedabad since last 5 years.
Mm-hmm.
So what we have come up with, mm-hmm. since our 5 years of experience is,
mm-hmm.
the developers, you know, came to know about the new technologies that are emerging,
mm-hmm.
right, which are running in the market, which they are not aware about it.
Okay.
Or, you know, they are finding the question on the Stack Overflow. And
correct.
And over here, they are, you know, directly getting interact with the that
developer.
Person.
Yes. Okay. Yes.
With the same mindset and with the one, you know, with they can get the proper knowledge of their particular domain.
Correct.
Rather than so this is not like, you know, any tech marketing kind of event. This is purely tech knowledge sharing
okay.
platform that we are building since last 5 years, and we are looking forward it to, like, you know, to make it as big as possible, because we got the feedback from the participants that they are getting more knowledge, they are getting motivated.
Okay.
Just before 3 days, we got a feedback from a student that just because of the GDG Ahmedabad, they came to know about progressive web apps, and he did a final year project in progressive web app.
Oh, that's nice. So how often these events happen in Ahmedabad?
Okay, so we GDG Ahmedabad organize monthly meetups.
Okay.
Now it depends on the, you know, availability of the venue and the speakers.
Okay.
But minimum we organize at least one event in a month.
Okay. So what is the process that you guys follow to choose speakers?
Okay, so in choosing the speakers, what we see in the speakers is his knowledge background, how he's working towards the technology or the topic on which he's going to deliver. Right, and the other thing is his speaking skill to the participants,
like how the speaker would accommodate all the speakers with his
right.
content.
Right.
So, all right. So, where do you think in next couple of months the GDG Ahmedabad will drive all this developer events? Like, you know, what could be the future?
This is actually like. If I can say, this is totally, you know, participants based community.
Yes.
Right. If there is no any participants, there is no any community.
Correct.
So this is totally based on them. So right now, according to my experience, what I'm looking at is the participants are, you know, getting more and more. They are encouraging us to drive it, you know, like at most recent topics to get delivered to them so that, you know, they can have this. So we always, you know, in approach with the developers who are actually, you know, getting hands that dirty with the native technologies.
Correct.
So we are just, you know, we are not looking for the experts. Mm-hmm. We are looking for the person who have experienced it and who can share his experience to the other developers.
Brilliant.
So that, you know, they can learn that, you know, you should not do this, mm-hmm. otherwise do this, because I have already done this and it doesn't work.
Nice. Okay, one more quick question. So all this rockstars developers of Ahmedabad, what's your final tip, like, you know, for them?
Okay, it's not like a tip. It's just like whatever you're doing, just keep doing and share whatever you have.
Yes.
Because sharing is caring and sharing is sexy.
Wow. So that's it from Dumil. I'm Ashok Kumar signing off GDG Ahmedabad.
It's anywhere around, like it's up to you guys. Like let's say, like a lot of times, like how I got into conversion, whenever like I pushed a commit, I am waiting for my co-worker to review my code. In the meantime, like I was just trying to convert some of the utility class. I was just trying to write some more tests in Kotlin. That's how I got started with Kotlin. So overall, like Java and Kotlin is very it is interoperable to some extent. There are some gotchas, like you need to do some extra work to make it interoperable, for similar to companion, but that is not hard thing to do. You can just go, like, start with one file and you can definitely go get to 100%, maybe like in